지원하게 접할래 닦아나. Thank you. ಇತ್ತೀಚಿನ ದಿನಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಇವರು ಎಲ್ಲಾ ಜನರಿಗೂ ಪರಿಚಯ ಆಗಿರುವಂತ ಒಬ್ಬ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿ.
ಆಫ್ ಗಾಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಅವರ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್. ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು. ನಾವು ಹೆದರುವಂತ ಜನ ಅಲ್ಲ. ಯಾವುದೂ ಕಾನೂನು ತನ್ನಿ, ಏನ್ ಬೇಕು ಮಾಡಿ, ನಮ್ಮ ಧರ್ಮವನ್ನು ಹಿಂದೂ ಹುಡುಗಿ ಹತ್ರ ಮದುವೆ ಮಾಡಿ ಆ ಹುಡುಗಿ ಮುಸ್ಲಿಂ ಆದ್ರು, ಅವರ ಮನೆ ಹೋಗಿ ಬೆಂಕಿ ಆದ್ರು, ಇನ್ನೊಬ್ರು ಕ್ರಿಶ್ಚಿಯನ್ ಆದ್ರು.
ಸಂವಿಧಾನದಲ್ಲಿ ಸಾಕಷ್ಟು ಕಾನೂನುಗಳು ಇದೆ, ಈ ಕುರಿತು ಇನ್ನಿತರ ಯಾವುದೇ ಕಾನೂನು ಅವಶ್ಯಕತೆ ಇಲ್ಲ ಎನ್ನುವುದು ನಮ್ಮ ಧರ್ಮಾಧ್ಯಕ್ಷರ ಒಂದು
ಮನವಿ. Including the Muslims, the Buddhists.
ಸಂವಿಧಾನ ಶಿಲ್ಪಿ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಬಿ ಆರ್ ಅಂಬೇಡ್ಕರ್ ಅವರೇ ಯಾವುದೇ ಸರ್ಕಾರಗಳ ಅನುಮತಿ ಪಡೆಯದೆ ಬೌದ್ಧ ಧರ್ಮಕ್ಕೆ ಮತಾಂತರ ಆಗಿರುವುದು ನಮಗೆಲ್ಲ ತಿಳಿದ ಸಂಗತಿ.
So what is today's speech you've been saying? The government is going to pass the anti-law bill. So what's it?
No, there is a proposal or a discussion doing rounds that government may come up with anti-conversion bill in the winter session of assembly. The Christian community leaders along with other community leaders today have joined here to express their strong resentment at this move. If there is any conversion by fraud or by deceit, there are enough provisions in the law to deal with such a situation, and the victims can approach. Actually, this is an effort to stifle the freedom of expression and the freedom of religion that is guaranteed by the Constitution. So there is no reason for such a bill to be enacted, which will only embolden the antisocial elements. So we express our strong resentment and opposition to this move. We as Muslims join our Christian brothers in appealing to the government to rescind from taking such a measure.
Not only against the Christians, it is, that means to say that any religion, anybody who gets converted gets penalized. It can be a Muslim, it can be a Buddhist, it can be a Sikh, it can be anybody. We are protesting our rights. ಆದ್ರೆ ನಾವು ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಒಂದಾಗಿ ಆಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಯುನೈಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಫೈಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಆಸ್ an assault on the constitution of India. We are all Indian citizens, we know our rights, and why, I don't think we are protesting as Christians, but all communities have to come together and protest this anti-constitutional bill.
Yeah. Thank you.
With him requesting the same with the same demand, and now that even after two visits there was no results, and that's why you have organized this peace assembly today. Do you think that this peace assembly will yield any results? Will the government heed, and in case what in case the government continues with its move?
Sir, we have tried our best. As you said, we met the government two times. We have sent many of our delegations and also memorandums to him, and today we have publicly also expressed ourselves. And surely, perhaps we will have to think of new ways and measures in order to impress the government. For example, in Belagavi, where the session is going on, there is going to be a Sardi Upavasa. People are going to fast there for the 7-8 days of this assembly, day and night they will fast. We will try our best to this one, because we know that majority of the Hindus, majority of the Muslims are with us, and they are very happy with us. And the Chief Minister is a gentleman. I like him, and surely he's a great man. His father was a great personality, and you know the S.R. Bommai court case judgment also spoke of secularism, and Mr. Bommai, his son, should remember this. And Mr. Bommai, 12 years back when the attacks took place in Mangalore, and Mr. Bommai was one of the ones who protested that the Christians should not be disturbed. He was in the, I think he was in Janata Dal that time, And 12 years now, he seems to be encouraging these groups and vigilante to attack us. I don't think this is a good move. So in Belagavi also, we will try to impress upon him, and we leave it to God. We leave it.